Episode of Bulldog Weekly.
My name is Jenny Thomas.
And I'm Michaela Engshed.
Today, we've got some interesting segments. Let's take a look.
Thanks, Maddie, for making that cool video. Here's all of the things that we're going over today. And up next is Grace's video, I think.
Yeah!
One Teacher of the Year award for her work here at RB. So let's check out this video of her.
I'm Patty Sarkady. I am in the Applied Arts Department here at Riverside Brookfield High School. Specifically, I teach business and technology courses here, and I've been here since 1999. The Illinois Digital Educators Alliance is an organization that has been around for decades that has promoted teachers with using some sort of digital technologies within their classroom. I've been very fortunate to be a part of this organization for over 2 decades. I've been able to continue on presenting both at local and national conferences, not only about technology, but also gamification and how best practices in your classroom, how to align career and tech ed learning objectives. Trying to find new ways to engage our students is key. And technology really helps embrace that way of thinking because there are so much technology going on in our daily lives, in the workplace, and a lot of the things that we do in my class is work-based readiness, employability skills, in addition to all of the content. And so technology fits hand in hand. So it's a perfect fit. And I'm very fortunate to have really embraced technology in my career. I was honored with the 2024 IDEA Educator of the Year Award, based upon the use of technology in my classroom. And not only the use of technology in my classroom, but what my students are also doing with technology. So it's not just the distribution of the content and facilitating the classroom use, it's really what the students are also creating and inventing. A lot of my game design students are publishing their own games that they've coded or animated. And it's worldwide, so anyone can access their games to play. My business marketing students are also using technology in a wide variety of ways. It's an honor to receive this award. I'm so grateful to the IDEA community, and I can't thank my colleagues enough. I can't thank my students enough. Without my students, I wouldn't even be where I am today. So I want to thank my students wholeheartedly from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
We've got a lot happening for Bulldog Weekly. We did a 7-day film challenge, so enjoy that.
Hello? Is the subject at its location? Mission 7 is underway. I can't tell you over the phone, but there's more.
Cut!
Oh, come on.
The line is, there's more, but I can't tell you over the phone. Run it again.
Take 102.
Action.
Hello? Is the subject at its location? Mission 7 underway. There's so much I have to say, I just can't tell you over the phone.
Cut!
Oh,
Boss, are you sure she's the right person for the job?
Light boy, you're in.
Hi, Mom. I don't know what happened. It was really bad, and I got fired off the set, and there's more. I just can't tell you over the phone. Oh my God, I'll call you back.
Hello? Is the subject at its location? Great, mission certificate. Is another
son of a...
Okay.
Today we will leave you guys off with a documentary made by Jenny Thomas, Liam Cohane, and Liam Hickey about Arby's first girl kicker.
The only challenge or like main obstacle I would say is just the fact that I was a girl.
Having Neve on the team has been unbelievable. I mean, we knew we were looking for a kicker after Iggy left last year, so it was a position that we definitely needed filled. And I mean, you can't argue with a kicker that's only missed 3 extra points so far this year. So,
I think I had a good season. I went 42 for 45 on extra points, which was really just surprising because obviously never playing the sport before. I did my research on my own, watching videos, like figuring out stuff like that, practicing, just making sure I was doing everything correct.
She reached out to me actually right before we started up in August. We knew that kind of throughout the summer that we were looking for a kicker. We had a couple guys who were able to make a couple, but not with the consistency that obviously we need as a varsity football program.
So I actually had to get a locker in the auto shop, which was pretty funny. So every day I'd have to ask for the keys, go in there, change, come back out.
You can just tell that she's a workhorse, man. I mean, on top of playing football, she's also playing travel soccer right now. So on the weekends, she's competing with her travel soccer team. She's gonna be a member on the basketball team. So having a three-sport athlete on the team is something that we can't really replicate. It's something that we're very grateful for.
Yeah, Styler helped generally. And then I had Coach Kane and Coach Bojack help me more during practices and stuff. My favorite game was probably Morin, just because it was the first game. It was my first time kicking. I went like 5 for 5 or 6 for 6. I could hear the student section. Like, it was just like a feeling that like I won't get to experience again, and it was just like really awesome.
Thank you so much for watching this Bulldog Weekly. Hope to see you next time.